Hello, welcome back to another vlog. I just got out the shower a little bit ago. My hair is air drying, so that's why I kind of look like this. Happy Friday. Well, when I'm filming this, it's Friday. I thought I would do a little weekend vlog this weekend because we have some like fun things going on, kind of. I mean, not really. Tonight is Friday, like I mentioned. We are going to a drive-through light show. We're gonna take Archie to the light show, which I think we did this when he was like a baby last year. I don't remember, but either way, he wouldn't remember. He's not gonna remember this either, but nonetheless, he's a little older, a little bit more like interactive, and I feel like he would enjoy a light show. So we got tickets to a light show nearby. I forget the name of it, but while we're there, like, I'll show you guys clips of it and I'll tell you what it is and everything like that. You stay in the car and you kind of just drive through different lights, tunnels, and like they play Christmas music and stuff. So it'll be the first festive thing we do this holiday season so far. So I'm excited about that. We're getting takeout for dinner tonight. I'm so excited. Angel and I literally woke up this morning and we're both like, yes, we're getting Chinese takeout tonight for dinner. I've cooked dinner for 2 weeks straight. Like, we didn't eat out for 2 weeks. We had family visiting 2 weekends ago and it was like nonstop going out and just doing way too much. So we just took a break from going out, doing anything. We were definitely under the weather for a little bit there too. So we just buckled down, stayed home, and I did like one big grocery haul. And I've been cooking dinner every night, even on the weekends for the past 2 weeks. So this will be like the first eating out we do. Thanks, babe.
I sound like a fly. That's the only one in my red bag. So the other one has to be weird stuff.
Okay.
The gray one.
I have no idea. but yeah, so it was nice to eat in and like literally go through every bit of groceries that I had in our refrigerator and in our pantry. So tonight we're gonna finally eat out. We're gonna have some Chinese takeout. What is your favorite Chinese food item? Like, for us, we always get shrimp fried rice, shrimp with broccoli, fried chicken wings, and a side of General Tso's chicken. That's like our go-to when we do Chinese takeout. It's my favorite. I've had it like growing up. That's what we always got too. So it's really yummy. I'm really excited to go to the light show and get some Chinese food, maybe cuddle up, watch some Christmas movies finally, because we haven't done that either. And then tomorrow is gonna be a super weird, crazy day. So my mom is right now in Texas. She's been in Texas with my youngest sister. She had a baby last month, 2 months ago now. He's 2 months old. And you know, it was definitely a wild roller coaster ride. But thankfully, he's doing so good, so strong, getting bigger and better every single day. And now that he's doing really well, and my sister and her family are all doing really well, my mom's gonna come back to Jersey. And I'm flying out tomorrow to go get her, because it's just safer for her to fly accompanied. So I'm gonna fly out tomorrow into San Antonio and then get her and leave in the same day, because my nephew is still so small and, you know, I've been traveling and all this stuff. We just didn't feel comfortable for me to stay in San Antonio to visit with them until he gets a little bit bigger and just his immune system is a little bit stronger and all that stuff. So unfortunately, I won't get to visit with my sister at all. It's literally a 24-hour trip while I fly out of Philly into San Antonio. We have like a few layovers in the middle of all that and then fly right back in. We get back at midnight. So I thought I would do some clips of like my travel day tomorrow, see what I capture. It should be an interesting day. I've never had a day where I just fly somewhere and then come right back. So it'll be a really long day for me. And I figured I'd take you guys along for that. But That's what I have going on so far. Sunday, I won't even bore you with the details of Sunday just yet, but if you're interested, then I hope that you'll follow along with our weekend vlog. Okay, so it's several hours later. As you can tell, it's kind of dark now, but we're on our way to Diggerland, right? What is the town that it's in?
I think it's Berlin.
It's in Berlin, so if you're familiar with South Jersey, it's in the Berlin area. And they're gonna have like turn a light
right,
show.
Then turn right.
So we're on our way there now. Archie's in the back, but you can't really see him. It's so dark. There he is. And then after that, we're gonna go get our food. Let me put my seatbelt on. Okay, chill. Which I'm super excited about. I've not stopped talking about it, but yeah. All right, I'll show you guys the lights once we get there.
Lights. Liberty Bell. Good job. Race car drivers.
Wow, baby. So cool. First candy cane. Yummy.
Took it all the way. You really got it in your face. Got that Chinese, boy!
Here, finally!
Check it if you want. No, traffic.
No, I'm not checking. It's taken us so long to get back across town because traffic has been so bad.
People are getting hit by cars.
Yeah, there's like so many pedestrians out tonight, which is so weird. It's 47 degrees, so it's not like that cold outside, but not warm enough to be going on a walk. But yeah, it's been pretty bad. And it's already 7, which means it's Archie's bedtime and he still hasn't even had dinner. So hopefully
and you still
okay. He's getting restless back there. I'm not even gonna bother trying to show you him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, everyone's hungry, so we gotta go.
That's all.
All right, mama's turn. Give me some love. Can I have a kiss too? Love you. Let's go turn your sound machine.
Oh, he's so sweet. Turn your sound machine on. Let me see.
Turn it on.
Go ahead.
Turn it on. Gentle.
You messed it up. Being
do
goofy.
Do it again. Do it gentle. Okay. No. Try again.
One more time.
No, let's do it a few more times. Okay.
Try again. It again.
No, again.
Again.
Okay. There it is.
Hey.
You did it. Good job. Say bye.
Bye. I love you.
He'll see you guys on Sunday. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Okay, so it's like 8:30 something at night. Just put Archie down and said goodbye to him. And I'm getting like my stuff together. So tomorrow morning is super quick and seamless on my way out of here. So I'm gonna show you what I'm bringing. This is gonna be my airport outfit. I got these super comfy sweatpants from Cotton On. Cotton On tank top, and then this Champion oversized sweatshirt, and that'll be my like travel attire, like what I'm gonna wear to the airport, and then some sneakers. I have just a backpack that I'm gonna bring with me on the airplane, and I have like a few things I'm bringing my laptop, my charger. I have some souvenirs that I picked up for my nieces and my nephew from when we went to Mexico. So I'm taking those down to them. I've got, that'll be the bag that I bring with like a pair of like overnight clothes. We get back from San Antonio like really late and we fly into Philly, and then I have to drive my mom down to her house, which is like a 45 minute drive from the airport. So I'm gonna pack a bag to stay the night at my mom's house. And then she's getting back to her house, and her house is, she's gonna need like groceries and everything like that. So on Sunday morning, I'm gonna take her to go get her groceries and stuff. So I also packed myself some pajamas for me to shower after we get back from the airport and change, and then an outfit for Sunday's errands as well. So that'll go in that duffel bag. That duffel bag will just stay in my car. I'm gonna leave my car parked in like the short-term parking lot. And then I have a few toiletries. So I have this, I like to pack little bags like this to keep everything nice and organized. So I have this little bag with hand sanitizer and lotion and a little small perfume. And then this one has deodorant, tampons, Advil, things like that. And then I'll throw my toothbrush in there too. I also have these other little packing cubes that I usually pack when I go on vacation, but I'm not gonna need anything. I'm not obviously bringing much at all. And then I just have to remember to pack maybe another little bag from in here to put like my chargers and stuff. So maybe I'll do this one. I'll put my AirPods, my laptop charger, my iPhone charger, a battery pack, and that kind of stuff. So that's what I'm doing for the rest of the night. I'm gonna wake up like around 4:30 in the morning, try to get out of here by 5 a.m. And I'm gonna shower in the morning because it's gonna be a long day and who knows when I'll get a chance to shower again. So that was Archie. So that's pretty much it. I'm gonna end the vlog here. I'm gonna finish packing and I'm gonna just take my makeup off, get into some pajamas, and hang out with Angel, watch a show on Netflix, and then try to get to bed a little bit early tonight, since I have such an early day tomorrow. But I'll catch you guys in the morning. made it to the airport. I'm parked in the short-term parking lot, and it's gonna be $44 a day, so hopefully it doesn't end up being any more than that. I have my stuff here. One of the bags, I didn't even show you. One of the bags is gonna stay in my car, and then I'm taking just a backpack, but I need to run inside. It's already 5:45, and we board at like 6:20. I think so. I have like less than an hour to get through everything. So I'll see you guys later on the plane. I don't know. That was insanity. Luckily I was able to check in on my phone. So I have my boarding pass on my phone, but security was just as bad. I'm about to get on my flight. It's a super tiny flight. We have a layover in Boston, so I'll be there for a second. And then on to San Antonio. But hopefully it's a quick and easy flight. Step outside, get some fresh air. That flight was so long. It was like a 5-hour flight from Boston because there was like bad weather. So it took a lot longer to get here than I thought. Not a lot longer, but it took longer to get here than I thought. And I just wanted to stretch my legs and stand up for a little bit because I've been sitting on an airplane for like way too long. I got like a little nauseous on that flight, which I don't usually get nauseous on flights, but my skin is so dry. But I definitely felt nauseous on this drive. On this flight. But actually coming outside, I feel better already. So I guess I just needed some fresh air. But I'm just waiting for my sister to get here with my mom. I'm like really sad that I'm in Texas. I can't believe I'm in Texas and I'm literally not even gonna be here for like 5 hours. Like, I'm here and as quickly as I came, I'm leaving right away. It's kind of weird and it feels like super sad to not be able to stay. I feel like homesick. Like, I feel like I'm home and I don't get to stay. I definitely miss Archie and Angel so bad. Every little boy I see, and even girl, like every kid I see, oh great, I already got a breakout. Love that. Every little kid I see, there's a kid right in front of me right now, so cute. I'm just like, oh, I miss my kid. So it is nice that I get to go straight home and I won't miss them for very long, but I'm very sad that I wasn't able to spend more time here in San Antonio visiting with my sister, visiting my nieces, meeting my nephew. But we'll just have to wait for another time when it's a little bit safer and he's a little bigger and healthier and all that jazz. So anyway, I'm just gonna chill out here. It's kind of cold in Texas. Drink some water and get a little more fresh air. Hopefully they'll be here soon. But I'll see if I can grab a few clips of the exchange, because I'm telling you, it's probably gonna be so quick. I know, el señor en el, cuando están chequeando la ID, dice, son hermanas, ¿verdad? On our way to Houston, hopefully we'll get some food there, because I have not eaten and neither has mom. And then, we'll be in Philly tonight. First thing he wants to do together is read a book. No surprise there.
Abba.
A book?
Abba.
Okay, come here. Can I have it? Can I have it? Okay, thank you. What do you say?
Please.
Please. Okay, come on. Hey guys, so it's a few days later and I realized I never like ended the vlog for the weekend, and I didn't want to leave you guys just like hanging on a clip of, I think the last thing I filmed was like me seeing Archie after coming home. So I wanted to fill you in on the rest of the trip because it was a little crazy, which explains why I wasn't able to like get any more footage or like do any more updates about everything. So I wanted to end the vlog, properly end the vlog, and let you guys kind of know the events that transpired on the rest of that flight, the rest of that trip. So one of the last things you probably saw was my sister Jennifer and her husband dropping my mom off at the airport. It was super sad because just because, you know, I was flying, I also had been under the weather like the week prior to that. We just did not want to risk any type of exposure at all to Jennifer or to the kids with my nephew's like conditions and things like that. And he's just so small that we didn't even hug, and you'll see that in the clips. Like, I didn't even get to like physically touch them or anything like that. So that was really sad. Some tears were shed for sure, but I totally understand, and like, you know, I totally get it. It was sweet to be able to see my nieces from afar and wave to them and get to like take a quick little sneak peek at my nephew Jax in his little car seat. So that was the exchange. We came, me and my mom went into the airport, back into the airport, and we checked in, checked her luggage, went through security, all the way through security, just to realize once we had gotten through security that we went through the wrong security,
gate, like the wrong TSA booth. The airport in San Antonio has two different TSA booths and they don't intertwine, like they don't meet at any point. So one side is for a certain kind of flight and the other side is for a different flight. So once we were done, the guy was like, sorry, you're gonna have to come back out, get all your things, dress yourself, put your shoes back on and all that, and go across the airport, which, fine, whatever. So we did that. And so we were just like rushing around to like get to our gate, but we made it with plenty of time to spare. That flight was overall a good flight. It was quick. My mom felt fine. For those of you that don't know, like the reason I had to travel with my mom, like fly to Texas just to like bring my mom home, is because she can't fly alone due to her medical conditions. She suffers from a few medical conditions, one being epilepsy, which causes her to have seizures. And in the last, I would say, 7 years, 7 to 5 years, she has had seizures on flights, so she can't fly alone. But she's been doing really good in the like more recent years, I would say within the last 2 years. She has flown without any sort of like issues, but nonetheless, you know, I took the trip out there to bring her back to Jersey. So we get on the first flight, and that one's from San Antonio to Houston. Super quick, super smooth, no issues. We got to the Houston airport, try to find something to eat. We ended up getting Shake Shack. It was not great, but we had to eat something. And then shortly after getting food and everything like that, we jumped on the next flight. So the next flight was from Houston to Philly, and that flight was like, I want to say like 2 hours and 45 minutes, like that was the duration of the flight for the, that's what I believe it was, I'm not sure. So we get on the flight, and my mom and I aren't sitting together. So, I was able to switch with someone, which was super nice of the girl to agree to switch with me. And then I sat with my mom, I sat on the aisle, my mom sat in the middle, and then there was another passenger in the window seat. So we're doing good, everything's fine. They have movies on the flight, so my mom's watching a movie, and I'm watching something, and she starts to get like a cramp on her side. And I try to like not to panic, but I have a feeling where this could be going. And she starts to kind of like say like, oh, I'm cramping up, I'm cramping up. And I can see in her face she's getting panicky, like she's starting to look a little bit panicky. So I was like, okay, mom, just calm down, like, you know, I can get up so that you can stand up and stretch, walk down the aisle, maybe go to the bathroom, splash some water on your face, because that is the routine for her when she's starting not to feel too well. The issue with that was that they were doing the beverages and snacks, so the carts were in the aisle and they just so happened to be behind us and in front of us, so we were literally sandwiched in between two carts. And quickly it escalated from a cramp to her saying, like, starting to like hyperventilate and say like, I'm not feeling good, I don't feel good. And I'm like, do you feel like you're gonna throw up, like what's going on, mom, talk to me. Super intense, and I already knew where this was gonna go. She was gonna have a seizure. And so I let the girl know, the one that was sitting, the passenger by the window, I was like, listen, my mom has epilepsy and she's most likely going to have a seizure. And she's like, oh my god, like she looks so scared. And I'm like, just calm down, like there's really nothing that I can do at this point. So I let the stewardess know, like, can you move the cart, my mom's not feeling well, she needs to go to the bathroom. She's like, is she okay, is she gonna throw up? And I'm like, can I have a bag just in case she does? So she runs off, tries to get me something for my mom, but like it all happened in seconds. As soon as she got back, my mom started to convulse. It was super scary, and it was super scary, and it was like just a shitty situation to be in because you're in tight quarters. I can't do anything for my mom, and luckily she's on medication for this. Like I mentioned, she has epilepsy, so she takes medicine to prevent seizures. But I just think that the altitude of the plane, the close encounter, like the enclosure of it and all of the things, just kind of caused her to fall into a seizure. Luckily, because of the fact that she's medicated and all that stuff, it was relatively mild. It was long, but it wasn't like a violent seizure, which she has had in the past. Growing up, I always used to experience these really violent seizures with her, where her body is like convulsing and jumping and violently like slashing around, and you know, it was bad. It was bad. Her head would be slamming and all the things. But luckily, thank God, that wasn't the case. She kind of just went completely numb. I felt her whole body weight just sink into her chair, and I just kind of held her head. The stewardess were super like nice and like asking me what they could do. They gave me something to fan her with and some really cold, like wet compress, like towels with ice and water, and I put the towels on her neck. She was starting to get like a little sweaty, and I could see her eyes kind of like rolling inside of her like eye sockets, and I kept just calling to her and saying like, mom, are you okay? Like, mom, can you hear me? And there was just nothing else I could do. There was nothing that anybody else could do. And so I just kind of had to let it pass. It was a little bit of a longer seizure. I feel like it lasted like a decent amount of time. Like, she was out of it for a while. Like, there was a point where like maybe like it was like 4 minutes of her having the seizure, and then she like finally opened her eyes, but then she like went back, and she just gets really tired after the seizures. But I would say the whole thing was over in like 30 minutes or less, like probably even less than 30 minutes. It just probably felt pretty long for me. And then like she woke up and she was just so tired. Like, she looked like she maybe ran a marathon or something. And luckily, thankfully, like, I was just praying the rest of the flight, like, please just let her get through the rest of this flight. We still had an hour and 45 minutes of fly time before we made it to Philly. They asked if we needed an ambulance when we got there, which I declined the ambulance because I was talking to my mom after she came back, and I knew she was going to be okay as long as she didn't have another seizure, which thankfully she did not have another seizure. She was good for the rest of the flight. It was just hard, and you know, it was just a difficult situation. When we landed, they had a wheelchair for her. The wheelchair took us to the baggage claim area. We got my mom's luggage, and I was parked super close to the terminal, so we were able to walk to the car together. And on the car ride home, she was totally fine again, and I'm so thankful that that was like the worst of it. And that's it. And then, you know, it was super late. It was like 1 o'clock in the morning by the time I made it back to my mom's town. She lives 45 minutes away from the Philadelphia airport. I decided to stay with her because I just wanted to monitor her, obviously, and just, I didn't want her to be like by herself that night. So I stayed the night there. She did really good. I'm like talking way too much. This is like 10 minutes long already. She did really good. She slept fine. She woke up feeling good the next morning. We ran some errands together, and I made it back to my house around like 1 p.m, which was later than I had hoped to get home. But I got home around 1 p.m. I had done groceries with my mom because she needed to get groceries and everything like that for her house. So I did the groceries for my house. I unpacked the groceries, finally took a shower, and then Archie woke up from his nap. So when I got home, he was napping. By the time I was done everything, Archie had woken up from his nap, which is perfect, and I got to say hi to him finally. And I think you will have seen those clips already. If not, then that'll be after this. But nonetheless, it was a little bit of a dramatic flight. I actually got hit in the head with a luggage on the first flight when we were going from San Antonio to Houston, the shorter leg. The lady behind me, she had a baby with her. She had gotten up in the middle of the flight to like grab something from the overhead compartment, and she never shut it. And when we were landing, a backpack, thank God it wasn't like a luggage with like wheels on it, because I would have for sure had a concussion or blacked out, because the way that backpack flew out of the overhead compartment, it like slapped me dead smack on my head. Like, it didn't hit my like the side of my head or my shoulder or my leg or my arm. It literally just went boom and like slapped me right on the top of my head. It gave me a super bad headache. And she was so sorry. She's like, I am so sorry, but like, honestly, I'm glad it hit me than her, because she has like a little tiny baby. She was like carrying a little tiny baby, and that would have like messed her baby up. Like, it rocked me. So I'm glad that it didn't hit her. So it was a dramatic second half of my trip. to say the least, but thankfully we made it home in one piece. My mom is doing great. She's doing totally fine. She's taking all her medication, and I talked to her multiple times throughout the day. I'm actually gonna go hang out with her this week and for the rest of the weekend. She's gonna end up coming back and spending some time with us. We just wanna like make sure everyone in my house is feeling good and healthy before I bring my mom over, because obviously we don't wanna get her sick or anything like that. So we're just like laying low this week. I got a lot of work to do this week as well, and also finishing up all the things that I have left to do for Christmas. So that's the end of this vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I hope it was kind of entertaining. I know it was like kind of like a pointless, it may seem like a pointless trip to some, but the reason why I had to, you know, fly to Texas and back in the same day is for all the reasons I've already explained. But thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the beginning clips of like us taking Archie to see the light show, because that's my favorite part of the weekend. It was like the only thing that was like fun that I did that was actually like an enjoyable part of the weekend. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.